personal communication channels, face to face, phone or internet chat communication. Word of mouth influence is also very critical. Buzz marketing cultivates opinion leaders. So therefore, people do not decide on their own. They also consult their neighbors. Okay, I want to buy a flat. Have you also purchased a flat from this particular builder? Okay, or have you also got this car? Before buying a car, you will take a walk in this neighborhood and see how many people have the similar car or car of similar make. Okay, so therefore, this is called buzz marketing. You are getting influenced by your people who have purchased in the neighborhood or your friend circle or in your society which you belong to. And non-personal communication channels, which includes media, atmosphere and events. So fifth step is developing an effective communication select message source. Okay, so highly credible sources are more persuasive. A poor spokesman can tarnish a brand, which means nowadays you see, for example, you choose, you know, celebrities to endorse your brand. Okay, so a celebrity who has not been scoring and who has fared badly, he is obviously a poor communicator for your brand. Step six, collect feedback. Whatever communication channels you adopt, you must constantly collect feedback and therefore assess the power of the communication tools which you are using in order to talk to the marketplace. Now, how do you send a promotional budget? Affordability, that is the first method. How much I can afford? 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs, 1 crore rupees. Percentage of sales method. Many companies follow this method. All right, if my sale is 100 crores, I am going to spend 5%, which is 5 crores rupees on my IMC overall expenditure for the year. Third method is competitive parity. Other companies are spending 7% or they are spending 6 crores. How can I spend 5 crores? So, competitive parity method. And lastly is a slightly more scientific, objective and task method. That what are the activities I need to carry out or the firm needs to carry out in order to communicate effectively to the marketplace, and what are the cost of each of these activities, and I must add up this cost and that becomes my budget. So, normally a firm will not use 1, 2 or 3 or 4. They might use mix and match each of these from time to time depending upon the case. Now, setting the overall promotional mix. Okay, how do you send the overall promotional mix? So, we have seen that the IMC consists of so many communication tools, some traditional and some because of the power of the internet today. And how do you set, okay, make this work for you, make work for the firm so that the customers eventually are predisposed favorably towards your organization. Let's look at the promotional tools. Okay, let's look at advertising first. It reaches a large geographically spread customer with high frequency. So when you want to take out a big ad all over Punjab, you go to put an ad in Punjab Kesari. You want to put All India ad, you want to put in Times of India, for instance. Okay, and it is, compared to the reach, it is relatively low cost, even though the overall cost of advertisement can be quite high, because it is actually a mass media. Customers perceive advertisement. Advertisement is also very popularly done, even more than newspaper, nowadays on TV. And you know how expensive TV spots are. Okay, right? A few seconds can cost you back by few lakhs. So customers perceive advertising goods as more legitimate because they see that if a company is advertising, it must have a good story to tell. Okay, so therefore, it gives a certain degree of legitimacy to the in customer's mind. And it dramatizes. Through a TV ad or through a newspaper, you can create a very nice story. Okay, you can create an image and therefore hope to convince the customer. And it builds brand image. If it does not directly sell the product, at least what it does is, you remember the brand when you go to the purchase institution, you go to a mall or you go to a retail outlet or you go to a bazaar. And it is impersonal. An advertisement or a billboard or a newspaper ad, it is impersonal. It is not targeted towards you as a person.